Hello everyone, I'm Nirupa Vyas, and I am the co-founder and managing director of two stem cell companies, Total Potential Cells Private Limited and Sushruta Innovations and Wellness Private Limited. We have been researching stem cells since 2007 for clinical applications. Now, you may wonder, what are stem cells and how do they work? Let me paint a picture with some examples. Picture this, wherein in a football match, one of the players suddenly gets injured on the field. The sports medicine doctor makes a diagnosis of an anterior cruciate ligament tear. This is followed up by a surgery to repair the tear. After that, it takes weeks of healing and months of physiotherapy and physical rehabilitation before the player actually gets back to the field. Or a tennis player or a cricket player suddenly develops a tennis elbow pain and has to take time out from the court. He or she may have to resort to steroid injections to resolve this pain. Another situation where a 45-year-old office goer gets debilitating knee pain. It is diagnosed as second-stage osteoarthritis. The advice that is given by mainstream medicine is to get a knee replacement done. Doesn't matter that the life of the implant may be only 15 years and a revision surgery may be required after that. Finally, think of a 75-year-old grandparent who gets diagnosed with Parkinson's disease. They are put on medication which will have to be taken for a lifetime. All that can be done is to manage symptoms, but this will not cure or reverse the disease. The classic scenario for all these conditions would be to give multiple drugs and surgical interventions. But with the advances in regenerative therapy, all these conditions have been helped with the help of mesenchymal stem cells, which is done at our labs. When regenerative therapy is opted for, the football player with the ACL injury would have stem cells injected from his or her own bone marrow, which would help repair, regenerate, and renew the cartilage much faster. This would enable the player to return to the field much faster and cut back on medical expenses. The tennis player gets an injection of a dose of stem cells made out of his own bone marrow at the site of the pain, and his pain is gone. The 45-year-old is given two stem cell injections into the knee made out of their own adipose tissue, which will help regenerate the worn-out cartilage. The natural joint is preserved, and the person gets 5 to 7 years to do physiotherapy and physical rehabilitation to push back the knee replacement surgery. The same process can be repeated. The stem cell therapy can be repeated after 5 to 7 years if the pain starts again pushing back the need of the knee replacement. The grandparent who was diagnosed with Parkinson's disease can be given stem cells from their own bone marrow into their spine, thus delaying the onset of the disease and maintaining the quality of life. These are just some of the uses of mesenchymal stem cells in regenerative therapy. What is regenerative therapy? Let us just elaborate this term a little further. Regenerative therapy is the therapeutic application of stem cells based on their potential to stimulate repair mechanisms and restore function in damaged body tissues or organs. Regenerative therapy utilizes human cells and tissue products. So the example is stem cell therapy, platelet-rich plasma therapy, to name a few. The human cell tissue product secrete compounds called growth factors and cytokines that aid in treatment with chronic and degenerative diseases. This therapy stimulates natural healing process by stimulating the reparative response to aging, diseased, dysfunctional, or injured cellular tissue. Some of the relief to the symptoms is immediate. The inflammation is cut down and the pain is gone. But the process of regeneration takes the investment of time, depending on the damage and the immune system of the person. Let us understand what are stem cells and how do they work. Stem cells are unspecialized cells in our body that can differentiate into various cell types and thus can help the process of regeneration. They have a property of angiogenesis, that is, they are capable of forming new blood vessels. They are anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial in nature. They also have the property of immunomodulation, that is, they can modify the body's immune response. And lastly, they stimulate regeneration at the site of the damaged or injured tissue. So, they are capable to repair, regenerate, and renew damaged tissues or organs. Now, let's take a deep dive into what are mesenchymal stem cells. The definition of mesenchymal stem cells is that they are multipotent stromal cells that can differentiate into a variety of lineages. That is, they have the ability to differentiate into cell types of different germ layers. That is, the ectoderm, that's the skin, mesoderm, the bones and the cartilage, and endoderm, the organs. Stem cells derived from the ectoderm, for example, that is the skin, can translate to form neural cells in the brain. So this phenomenon is referred to as cell transdifferentiation or plasticity. Mesenchymal stem cells are immunonaive. That means a person's immune response will not reject the mesenchymal stem cell transplant. Thus, this therapy can reach a number of people. There are various sources of mesenchymal stem cells. The bone marrow-derived mesenchymal stem cells are most commonly used and well-researched. Adipose tissue or fat provides a more abundant and easily accessible source of stem cells. Umbilical cord blood, umbilical cord, that's the Wharton jelly, and placenta are also rich sources of stem cells. The autologous cells are defined as the cells that come from a person's own body, and allogenic cells come from a donor tissue. So, bone marrow, adipose tissue, menstrual blood, dental pulp, all fall under autologous sources, while umbilical cord, cord blood, placenta are the allogenic sources. I can safely point out that many of the children who were sitting in the audience would have had their cord blood and cord tissue saved in a private cord blood bank. So, in case, at the time of the birth, if there was a complication, these tissues would have come in very handy for the child. Typically, if the child is not crossing milestones, the pediatrician or stem cell clinic will advise injecting the stored cord blood to achieve normalcy. But the parents and grandparents don't have their tissues stored. And that is where autologous regenerative therapy is very convenient, wherein their own tissues can be taken and processed in the lab and re-injected back at the damaged area to regenerate the damaged tissues. So, if any one of you requires stem cell therapy, all that you need to do is to look inside your body. So, mesenchymal stem cells find a lot of clinical applications in regenerative therapy. These we have been working since 2007. In the laboratory that we have set up to work on stem cells, we were granted a clinical trial by Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. The trial was to study adipose-derived stromal vascular fraction for the treatment of arthritis of the knee, that is osteoarthritis. 25 patients were selected for the clinical trial who had grade 2 to grade 4 osteoarthritis. The lab process was carried out at our GMP class 5 facility. The process of harvesting the stem cells has many steps. First, the plastic surgeon takes the patient into the operation theater, and with specialized cannulas, the belly fat is taken out. This is known as lipoaspirate, and the process is known as lipoaspiration. This tissue is then moved back to our lab, where the cells are harvested and a sufficient number of cells are brought out for treatment. Finally, the mesenchymal stem cell dose travels back to the operation theater where the patient is, and a qualified orthopedic surgeon will give intra-articular injections straight into the knee. Following criteria were evaluated to study the success of the therapy. First was the range of motion. There was an improvement of knee society score for range of motion criteria in all the patients after 12 months than the pre-treatment. The pain was reduced. The walking score was improved. Climbing of the stairs improved than from the pre-treatment. There is a visual analog score which talks about, which is subjective, but it is highly indicative of the patient's satisfaction. At the end of year one, 24 out of 25 patients scored between 9 to 10. So to sum it up, it establishes the safety and the efficacy of the adipose-derived mesenchymal stem cells for the treatment of osteoarthritis of the knee. The study has been published, and we have been awarded a process patent. I would like to describe my own journey with stem cell therapy. I had a ligament tear which impacted all my mobility, and I couldn't even walk properly. A surgery was advised, which I did not want to undergo. I was given 3 rounds of stem cell therapy over a period of 4 years. With constant physiotherapy and physical rehabilitation, I have been able to regain 95% of my joint health and movements. Other uses are for neurological conditions. Research suggests that stem cells have neuroprotective effects, which can help for treatment like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's diseases. By promoting neural repair and reducing neuroinflammation, mesenchymal stem cells could help preserve cognitive function as we age. Children with cerebral palsy are being given injections of stem cells into their spinal cord, and ample scientific data has been generated to show that the children start crossing the milestones after receiving stem cell therapy. During COVID, patients were given high doses of steroids to bring down the inflammation in their bodies. They subsequently developed avascular necrosis of the hip, that is, they would require a hip replacement to be done. 19-year-old, 20-year-old young adults were being advised to do hip replacement. Here, autologous cell therapy using stem cells from the bone marrow were injected in their hip joints, and the hip replacements was avoided, and they had good results. Mesenchymal stem cells are also being used for anti-aging therapies. So as we age, our cells accumulate damage and they enter into a state of senescence, wherein they no longer divide or function properly. The MSCs have been shown to secrete growth factors that can reduce cellular senescence and promote the regeneration of the diseases. Chronic inflammation is a hallmark of aging and is linked to many age-related diseases. So the stem cells, the mesenchymal stem cells, possess strong anti-inflammatory properties which can help reduce the inflammation. Other applications in anti-aging are for the rejuvenation of the skin and hair. Plastic surgeons and dermatologists aspirate the belly fat, out of which we make nanofat and microfat, which is rich in stem cells and in growth factors. This is being used in place of dermal fillers and Botox. It improves the skin elasticity, reduces the wrinkles. It promotes a more youthful appearance by stimulating the collagen production. Hair fall and hair thinning is affecting youths to adults. So mesenchymal stem cells, along with platelet-rich plasma, is given in the hair follicles. It is injected into the scalp in the hair follicles to stimulate and regenerate the follicles to achieve hair growth. The images that you see are the images of my 19-year-old son who started getting a balding patch. MSCs along with PRP were injected in his spot, and in 6 months, we had results that the entire balding patch was gone. There are challenges to the mesenchymal stem cell therapy. Different laboratories use different protocols, which can result in varying cell quality and potency. So it is very important that standardized procedures need to be developed, which will help ensure consistency across treatments. The production and administration of mesenchymal stem cell therapies is expensive, so it doesn't reach the masses. Lifestyle modifications are very important to the success of stem cell therapy. A smoker or drinker cannot expect any results out of stem cells if they do not quit their smoking and drinking. So, what I leave you all with is that the next time around, someone near you needs some medical treatment, please do research whether stem cell therapy can be an answer to that, and definitely do ask your doctor about it. When all of you sitting here in the very near future pick careers, research in the field of stem cells is an exciting proposition, and I request you all to definitely apply your minds to it. Thank you very much.